Yo, what's going on? I'm Jay.
It's Big.
This is Lit Logic. We are on episode 48.
Hey.
Meg is back in the building, ladies and gentlemen.
Again.
Meg the Fox.
Again.
What is it like? The fifth
appearance? Just like the fourth or fifth appearance.
Shout out to Meg for being so consistent.
Thank you guys for having
We really appreciate the consistency. See how I'm looking at the camera?
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, because shit gets silly, like when we extend an invitation and niggas just be, niggas look at it and just, you know.
I know, I always respond to
left on red and shit.
Yeah, I hate that.
Ha ha ha.
Bro, we let me on the show, blah blah blah, then that's it.
That's it.
That's fade it. Away into nothing.
Just see three dots.
Okay, so today's topic is infidelity, cheating, stepping
sneaky
out.
Links.
Sneaky links, however you want to call it. This was B's idea.
That's
so
wild.
I'm gonna let him. He the one that came up with the topic idea, so we gonna let him start.
Cheating. Honestly, I've never cheated before. Ever.
Never.
That's not my thing. I mean, you want to count when I was like in high school and I went to prom with somebody else? I mean,
somebody might have felt like that was cheating.
Maybe she couldn't go.
What do you guys like? What falls under the category of cheating?
I mean, but it.
That's it. That's so hard. That's it. Like, is it not like flirting? Is it not texting?
But see, that's goes on the partner that you have, because everybody has a different standard when it comes.
So to you, what's cheating? Like, what would be like? All right. You cheated on me. I'm gonna put a stamp on your head that you're cheating.
Obviously, fucking
getting the bottom knocked out.
Oh my god.
Oh.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep it together.
Jay Wild, yo. inappropriate conversations. You know, sexting, all that. You know, that's you know, considered cheating.
Yeah.
Even inappropriate touching, you know, that's just weird.
Yeah. What about you?
I agree. It's more so the actual act of having sex with somebody else for me.
So
like, I get the other stuff could be considered cheating, but I guess like the you know, the last straw or the bottom line would be actually fucking, and then.
Okay, so I have a question. So with all that being said, like, you know, you said like some things go hand in hand with cheating that you said, and you said you agreed to it. What would you consider something that's like the deal breaker for you to leave? Are you leaving a relationship just solely off them fucking? Are you leaving a relationship off them sexting? Are you leaving a relationship off them flirting, talking to someone that they're not supposed to be talking to? Like, what would be the icing on the cake to be like, you know what, I'm going to stamp you as a cheater and I'm breaking up with you?
If she sucked his dick.
So she can have sex with him.
It could be like, maybe I could get over this. It might take some time. You know, with this, that's like the deal breaker.
Fuck that.
So what about
you? I'm shooting shit up. Like,
Oh, so you're killing
him?
You say
no. No, like the deal breaker for me obviously would be like physical, you know, but I don't know. It depends, because it depends on how much you like the person, because
It depends on how much you hurt.
It hurts your feelings.
How much time it takes you to get over it.
Yeah, because I hold grudges, so I don't.
I do too, but can I say something? I feel like for me, like, and not to get like all like religious-y and stuff, but like the Bible says like the flesh is weak. So that means that like, you know, like people are going to be around temptation and stuff like that. So honestly, I'm at the point right now where if I found out my significant other cheated, and I'm not talking about like a reoccurring offender of a cheater, like, you know, he had sex with somebody, I would honestly be mad. It'll probably take me a while to get over. I'll probably have my little tantrum, block you for a little bit, make you work to get back to me.
Get on social media, start talking shit.
Oh my god, I actually haven't been doing that lately. Okay.
shout out to Snow. And then what?
So I honestly think that, like, if I found out they had sex, I don't think that I would necessarily, like, leave the situation. I might make the situation, I might make him work for the situation, but I'm not going to leave. Mm-hmm. I think something that's going to make me leave is a baby. If you go out and have a baby, I think that another situation that will really have me leave is if, like,
somebody, you know, like a friend or something.
Yeah, a friend, a family member. But also, I think that I will also leave, like, off the strength of, like, if I go through your phone or find out that you, like, talking to somebody or whatever, if y'all gonna cheat, leave me out of that. Don't make me the topic of this of discussion. Don't make me the joke of y'all discussion. Because it's like, you already out here doing a bad deed. You already cheating. So don't kick my back in. Don't sit here and
you get one. You be doing that?
To get pussy? Dang, niggas crazy. Will say anything. That's not my girl. We on a break. They'll sit here and, like, whole time they'll be, like, living with the person. Or they'll sit here and, like, downplay a person. Like, that will literally make me want to leave just off the strength of, you really have no respect for me. Like, you're already sitting here cheating, but, like, I'm the joke. You get what I'm saying? Like, just to make a hoe feel good, you'll sit here and say something, or just to make somebody giggle, you'll sit here and say something that you probably really don't even mean, but you saying it just to, like, get something from that other person that you're talking to. So, like, that's a no right there, because I already feel like, you get what I'm saying? Like, if you're cheating, you're already doing something bad. So, like, just if you're, I'm not sitting here saying I'm allowing cheating, but what I'm saying is, like, if you want to cheat, cheat. Like, leave me out of that. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, and don't bring me no messy situation with the whole you cheating. Now you got a stalker. Now she's disrespecting your girlfriend. Like, don't bring me nothing that comes from you cheating.
Now your tires getting slashed.
Yeah. Don't bring me nothing. If you want to cheat, that's your shit. That's your situation. Don't bring me nothing that I didn't ask for. Don't bring me no drama. I don't want no drama from the exes. None of that. And I feel like that's fair.
It is, but that never happens. It never happens that way.
Yeah. You mean to do, but then they don't. This depends on the situation.
It's always some shit.
It's never just a laundry list of things that happen. Shit go left, shit go right.
Absolutely.
So but I feel like if you're out here cheating, you will do everything in your power to not. You're gonna make sure you wipe your foot off of all that shit when you step in the house. You're not bringing that shit into your household. So your wife or your mom, nobody will ever fucking find out about that shit. That's why I always say, the older men, like the older generation, like our grandparents' age, or, you know, mm-hmm. like, and it was easier for them. These old men used to have families up in the north. They used to have families down south. And the two families never knew about each other. Because I feel as though the men tried harder back in the day to not let shit come together. You get what I'm saying? Now people have like social media as a platform or whatever. So it's easier for people to find people who liking this, who comment on this. You know what I'm saying? Like, they start being investigators and stuff. And I feel like that's how a lot of people use social media to find the other chick. You get what I'm saying? Or the person that person is dealing with or whatever. So, and, like, the guys, I feel like, and guys now, like...
Women too.
Yeah.
Okay, well, yeah. Well, I'm just going to say our generation in general, they make it cool to, like, be a pimp. You get what I'm saying? Like, oh, I got this, I got that, I got this girl, I got that girl, I have this girl, I have that guy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they make that. But back in the day, if the guys did it, they was, like, more of, like, a smooth criminal. Like, rolling stone. You get what I'm saying? Like, they did it, but it wasn't, like, really no mess that came with it. I just feel like...
Who made that song?
What, Smooth Operator? Mm-hmm. Sade.
Yeah.
Sade.
Yeah. So, I don't know. I'm not a fan of cheating. I do think, though.
Who's a fan of it?
I do think that, how should I say this? That once in everybody's relationship, at least once, it's going to happen. Whether if it's sex, flirting, inappropriate texting, whatever, it's going to happen at least one time. Now, if I forgive you one time, don't become a person that does it all the time. And it's going to be on some shit like, you get what I'm saying? You keep pushing it to the limit like Rick Ross and shit.
Like, well, see, that's the thing. You can't sit there and say, if I forgive you one, it shouldn't be a first time.
It shouldn't, but...
Well, you know what they said, fool me once, shame on you. Yeah. When we talk, right. No. What else J. Cole said?
No, it's fool me, what is it? Fool me once, that's shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
You can't put the blame on you.
Yeah.
Pull me three times,
fuck the peace signs.
Pull out the chopper, let it rain on you.
Okay, J. Cole.
Shout out to Cole, man.
Cole World.
Facts.
But yeah, it should never be a first time.
I agree. I feel like there should never be a first time. But again, the flesh is weak. So if something does happen, I'm quite sure.
Yeah, the flesh is weak, but the mind should.
That's true.
It should never, the mind
should. That's true.
This is how I look at it. You protect home. You protect what you like. People do and people say what they want.
Yeah.
So if you love and you like what you have at home, nothing outside should never interfere. That's just like if you got a 5-course meal at home, what are you doing eating McDonald's every day?
Right.
It just makes no sense. So that's what I'm saying. Like, and then on top of that, it goes off the guy or the girl, the respect they have for that person. Because if you have respect for that person, certain shit you won't even have to talk about because it just won't happen. So it all goes off the person.
But you know what? I like the fact that you said you could have a 5-course meal at home, but you still go eat McDonald's. There's people like that. Like
McDonald's is nasty.
They still eat McDonald's.
They'd be like, I just wanted fast food today. Like, okay.
I feel like cooking.
Yeah.
But not no damn McDonald's.
But sometimes people want something new. You get what I'm saying?
And in that case, if you want something new, what you have already, you let that go. Because that right there, you cause, like you say, confusion.
Right.
And then you get the all unnecessary drama.
Right.
And why have that if you can just let that go and then go try something
new? Because people are greedy. People will literally sit here and do anything in their power to try to have everything that they can if they can have it. So if you have something at home and she's a 5-course meal, but you want a little McDonald's, you want to go to McDonald's and get McDonald's just because you want to be greedy. Like it's the person. Yeah. They want to have a little dirty meal, you know? They want to...
And the ice cream machine better be working.
Or I'm coming back tomorrow.
Ice cream machine better be working.
That shit never working. But I mean, and also it's a 50-50 thing. Like you know, the guy, if you know the female, if they're going out doing their thing, the person at home, you gotta know subtle signs. And then you have to make that decision with yourself. Are you okay? Well, what's going on, or can you tolerate it, or are you going to say something? Because sometimes walking away, you're going to be hurt, but you're going to have your self-dignity, your self-respect, because you shouldn't have, people should never have to put up with shit they don't want to. You don't have to put up with shit. People put up with shit because they want to. You don't have to.
It's difficult, especially when feelings are involved, especially depending on how long you've been with the person. At some point, you just start to accept it.
But then that's the thing we talked about in like another, I forgot what episode, the emotional part and the rational part. The emotional part will always keep you into a situation that you should have been out of.
Yeah.
When you think rational about shit, you realize, oh shit, the 2 red flags I ignored actually was 30 that I ignored. And and I was constantly repainting over a person's colors that obviously kept fucking washing the paint off.
Yeah.
So... It, like I said, it all, sometimes you got to take the emotions out of thinking in a relationship and use irrational thinking. Like, what this person is doing is not making me feel good. Yeah, I may love the person, I may care, but at the end of the day, I'm not myself, you know, or I'm making myself sick. You know, it all depends on how, you know, whatever is going on in the relationship, but you have to make that decision.
I have a question. So, are you really... completely 100% happy with a person?
like I said, it all depends on the connection.
Because sometimes people will be like, oh, I went out and cheated because I'm not getting this at home. You get what I'm saying? Or they'll be like, oh.
When people say that, that's in a relationship, you voice your opinion. You don't sit there and constantly keep letting that shit slide. And then when it builds up and you go out and do your thing, that's the reasoning. And it's like, no, why didn't you say something?
Right.
I didn't know.
It depends. Sometimes you say stuff and stuff gets changed at the beginning. And then slowly but surely it's right back to
and that's when you have those conversations. And if that conversation is
how many times you have a conversation?
That's when you take the emotional part out of it and you put the rational. It's like, look, man, I'm asking you to do something. And if you can't do the shit, what if we do the shit?
I swear to God, let me tell you something. There was something that was going on in a relationship. Yeah. And I sat here and brought it to the person. And they took it as me trying to argue, like you're always trying to argue. And I said, you can't take what I'm saying as an argument when it's just a suggestion. Yeah. I'm sitting here telling you that I'm going to need this out of the relationship or I'm walking away. And then that person kind of took it as I'm always complaining. So in my head, I'm like, okay, then I might as well have not, you get what I'm saying? I might as well have not said anything and then be unhappy, but then I'm lingering somewhere else. You get what I'm saying? So I felt like it was mature of me to sit here and bring that up. Yeah, but I feel like in certain situations or whatever, people try to dance around their partner. So they'll try to avoid different conversations and stuff. So sometimes people feel as though that's why it's easier to go out and cheat. Trust me and believe, I'm not justifying cheating, but I know from conversations and I know from certain situations that I've been in, not saying that I cheated or anything like that, but I just know sometimes people try to dance around conversations that needed to be had so it won't start an argument. So if they're not getting something that they want at home or they, you know, something that they need, instead of having a conversation to better that, they're like, okay, well, we're doing good right now at home. Even though this is bothering me, I'm not going to say something because we're good. So I'm going to go out and I'm going to go get that satisfaction from somebody else because I'm not getting that at home. So, and I find that a lot. But some people are just like that. Like some people, you know, like having somebody that they can call, you know, their wife, their girl, and you know, and people like that are like reoccurring cheaters. That's something that I'm not dealing with because I don't have to. You get what I'm saying? Like I'm not even my mom's second child, so I'm not gonna come second to anybody. You know what I'm saying?
That's people accepting, you know,
people want some, oh, as long as he come home, I don't care. I don't give a fuck.
Because if you accept
that,
coming
home or not.
Because if you accept that and it keeps on happening, you can't complain about a heartbreak that you watch occur.
Hey man, sometimes when they in that situation, they doing their shit too.
Yeah.
They know what's going on and they out there doing their same shit too. It's usually more so when people got families together.
Yeah.
And they figure, listen, it's better just to keep the family together, do this together than try to, you know, separate.
Let me tell you, I'm mature enough. I'm not staying with no guy just because I got a baby by
him. Hey, listen, I get all that, but I'm just saying that these are certain situations that are going on right now.
You will literally drive yourself crazy trying to put on this picture family situation when it's not.
Y'all out there fucking with each other.
Exactly. So if you gotta leave, then leave.
There's so many different situations.
Oh, I'm tired of that. He's been on 10 on day.
There's so many different situations when it comes to this. Like, you know, somebody might be in a situation where someone is so loyal to somebody and they're out there just doing their thing and they can't help it, or in the case maybe, or they feel like they can't commit to just being with one person. Then you got situations where, you know, like I said earlier, they know what's going on. They're just doing their own thing, but they're staying together for whatever, so maybe family, or they just don't want to. Some people just don't want to start over.
Yeah. Some people are lazy.
Some people just, well, I'm too old to start over, blah, 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 like all the other shit. So it really just depends on the situation.
Let me tell you, like when there were situations where I got cheated on or whatever, mm-hmm. I used to like take it to heart because I'm like, it's something wrong with me. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? Like I would like, you know, and like that's when all like the insecurities and stuff come out or whatever. Like, you know, what can I have done to make this situation, you know, not go like this or whatever. But honestly, it's not you. I had to come to the conclusion that it's not me. It's that person. You get what I'm saying? Like, like literally, I don't put nothing past anybody. Martin Luther King cheated on Coretta Scott King. You get what I'm saying? And people think that they're like...
She was holding it down, too.
You get what I'm saying? And you... And
nigga was on the road a lot.
Yeah. Like, Jay-Z cheated on Beyonce. And people say Beyonce is one of the most beautiful people in the world. Holly Berry got cheated on. You get what I'm saying?
Like,
it's not
about the beauty.
It's not.
It's about the compatibility.
It's your beauty.
I knew he was going to be beauty.
It's the compatibility. Like, I mean, like, my mom always tell me, just because you look good, I don't mean...
You are good.
Yeah, you're exempt from the list. Like, right. She said, there's pretty... There's, like, my mom said, motherfuckers cheat on pretty girls or ugly girls all the time.
All the time.
Like, it doesn't matter. Like, it all... To me, I feel like it's the compatibility.
I'm going to say it before this episode over. What? You know what I'm talking about. And when you hear it, you're going to know why. But my bad, I didn't mean to cut you off. Because I had three separate cases where I couldn't send it. But anyway, my bad. I'm sorry, folks.
No, you're not.
No, I just feel like, it's the person. It's not the person who they're in a relationship with. And I swear, like, people will find a way to blame them cheating on you. People will... Oh, you aren't doing this, and oh, you aren't doing that, and like, it's a legit conversation.
And you know what people's mistakes are when they get in those conversations? They sit there and they believe that shit.
Yeah,
that's the thing. You
weren't
believe,
doing this, you weren't doing that, and the person sitting there like, you know what? Yeah, and then they start looking at themselves like, you know, they were the issue. Yeah,
it's like, I could have woke up out of my sleep and answered your phone call. Yeah, like, nigga, what?
I guess it really just depends on you.
Yeah,
because. I got cheated on, and she was trying to say that, because I was too good for her, and all this other shit, which, you know, she might have been right, but I ain't take it as, you know, there was something wrong with me. I was like, hey, Rich, I ain't too good for you.
I would have talked shit back.
That was a compliment. Like,
I guess it just depends on how you feel about yourself, but, you know.
Shout out to my boy, shout out to Glenn, man, because I would have been there shooting jump shots. Shout out to the mid-range jump shot. Remember?
You talking about Glenn Robinson?
Nah, our guest Glenn.
Oh, Champ. Shout out to Champ.
Shout out to Champ, man. Remember he said, you know, he said he wanted a nonchalant guy to working on his mid-range and mid-argument. Mm-hmm. Shout out to the jump shooters out there, Hoodie Mello.
Yeah, now I remember what you're talking about. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Well,
So have you guys ever cheated?
No. It's not like that. I mean, unless you want to talk about taking a girl to the prom. But, yeah, I took another girl to the prom.
Yeah, I mean, I have.
I was
a younger guy, so.
You know. And I don't think I consider what I did cheating as, like, when you're on a break, you know?
You know,
some people look at it like that. It depends on the conversation
I don't feel
that
like,
you have. Shout out to my boy Quay, because he went over this when he was on the show.
Look at this. You're
right there.
Don't
bring me in this shit. Don't bring me in this shit.
They said they had a conversation.
They wasn't going to look like a basketball dad.
They wasn't going to do that type of stuff. They was just taking a break. But you know.
But yeah, if you don't have
a conversation, then...
But even if you do have a conversation...
It's over the season.
But even if you do have a conversation on honest to God truth, motherfuckers going to do what the fuck they want to do regardless.
Right, yeah, absolutely.
You can have a conversation if you want, but if motherfuckers going to step, they going to do whatever they want. Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day...
Some people try to go on breaks just to do that.
Yeah, we're trying to start certain
arguments. Damn.
Let me make this person break up with me so I can go out.
You know what's crazy? There are motherfuckers that do that. Yeah, force argument. You know what? I'm tired of cold chicken. Fuck you.
Come in the crib. Why is this fork in the sink?
So you just don't wash dishes.
Okay. It's one fork. I'm tired of this shit.
I'm done.
I'm out. And they leave and they go right over there.
Yeah. Sick of this.
I can't believe you won't believe this shit, yo.
She leaving forks in the sink. She always eat like it's like nickel.
Like what? Well, yo, that's really how it goes down sometimes. Cause that's how they psychologically trick themselves thinking it's okay.
Like we're gonna be in the car.
Like, we're not on good terms no way.
Yeah, it's like fuck her. She always leaving spoons in the sink.
And as soon as the shit happened, we was arguing. We was on the break.
Damn.
That's how people think. So, what's the icing on the cake for you to leave?
I think we went over this already. Yeah. I explained my reason.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. All you did, you did, you did. So, how many times does the person have to do some fuck shit to you for you to leave?
Let me tell you something. You mentioned, if you whistle the shit, it's done. It's done. Like, they can have you. Look, I don't come second to nobody. So that's my attitude. That's how I've always been since I was a kid. I'm not good with sharing. I don't play well with others.
So what about if you're married?
Would you?
That
goes into a...
That's a sticky situation. Yeah, because it depends if you got kids.
Because some people, they'll sit there and be like, you know, because like, you know, they'll have, you know, infidelities and whatnot. And some people will keep it together, like you said, for the kids, for the family. Mm-hmm. But in the same case, by them keeping that together, kids notice everything, first off. They see shit. So if mom and dad are not happy, or they're trying to fake
kids
the pump...
Kids not happy.
Yeah, the kids are not happy. So you're damaging the kids because they're looking at that as a, you know, that's a real relationship. You know, and that's not good.
I'll say this. You got to take care of yourself first. Because you can't take care of nobody else if you can't take care of yourself. So... Facts. So if you're in this type of situation and there's something that keeps going on, and I don't have conversations and it keeps going on, yeah. It's time to go.
Absolutely. Like you said, like you, it's look, people do, like you said, people do what they want to do.
Mm-hmm.
People hear what they want to hear. How many times do you think you got to tell somebody something?
But that's what I'm saying. So how about if you're married, you have property with this person, kids with this person, accounts with this person,
so
everything.
So before you get married,
closing accounts inside the house. Closing accounts inside the house. Hey man, inside the house. Split
they say it's cheaper to keep her.
They do say that.
Yes, it is.
Especially if you're making more, you gotta pay alimony. I don't like that. Makes me, I don't like that shit.
She wasn't with you shooting in the gym.
Child support too.
18 years.
18 years. So it's a lot of things that some people would just rather just put up with the
rather
shit.
Rather be with you on your bullshit.
Some people rather just put up with the shit and just, like, listen, I ain't trying to pay the shit by myself. I ain't trying to pay no child support.
You know how much more it is to wake up to a motherfucker you don't like?
People
do it all the time.
I've seen this couple on Dr. Phil.
They like each other sometimes. You know, they laugh about some old shit and everything.
Yeah, and then it goes into an argument about some shit. Yeah, stupid ass.
They still be fucking.
And yeah. I've seen this episode of Dr. Phil. It was this couple. They had got divorced 2 years prior, but they were still living in the same house.
Mm-hmm.
They had kids.
They were still fucking.
No, she was trying to, like, but the thing is, she couldn't financially do stuff by herself. So she felt stuck with him.
Mm-hmm.
And he was still trying to get back with her and was getting mad when she was out doing her ones and twos. So then it just got to a point where I'm not your wife anymore, but he like, but you in my house.
And I'm paying for shit.
Yeah.
So they don't get me.
So,
ain't none of that happened.
Yeah.
Yet, huh?
So yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it's such a touchy subject because there's so many different ways to look at it.
So many avenues you could
have. So it's just like, well, what if you do if you're in this situation? Or what if you do if you're in that situation? It just depends on, I guess, how you're feeling at that time and how much your confidence in yourself and whatever your financial situation is, whatever, if you got kids or not, it's just so much things. Like,
I feel like, honestly, I can't tell you what cheating is. You can't tell me what cheating. Nobody can do that except you and your partner, because y'all have to have a type of understanding. Because some couples believe, like, if you love a picture, that's, I'm not going to say cheating, but you get where I'm going with this. You get what I'm saying?
Like I said,
if you like this.
That's how you feel, so, you know.
No.
Well, we got to check out Lit Logic episode. Now. I can't remember the episode.
I
don't
know
what it's on there.
I can't remember these
niggas loving pictures.
I call this shit off.
I was like, who you loving?
Oh, I think it was a social media episode.
Okay, well, yes. If you loving a picture and you're in a relationship, fuck is you loving?
I love all Rihanna pictures.
And that was definitely too loving. Do not be loving a little girl around the way picture, period, when you're with me. And that's the con- conversation. But like I said, that's, you know, join your partner. Some people believe that. Some people are like, oh, it's Facebook. Go, it's Instagram. That's what it's used for. Go ahead. Like, love, comment. You're not commenting.
She said you're not commenting.
Period. Like, another thing. I had this conversation with somebody. I remember I was in middle school. It was like a freaking dance. It was Princeton Day School.
We taking it back to them.
One of my friends and her boyfriend, they was just hopping around person to person, dancing.
Oh, that shit.
Another girl was like, my boyfriend ain't dancing with nobody but me, and they was grinding left and right all night. Just left and right all night. Then it was another couple who was like bouncing around. That's another thing that in relationships, it's another conversation you gotta have. Like, you know, it's dancing, it's touching. Like,
well, you know, all these conversations to have when y'all in the dating stage.
I'm too old to be dancing, doing that type of grinding and shit. Nah.
I mean, yeah, but you know, but what I'm saying.
Grind the bedroom, man. Who grind on the dance floor?
Yeah, and then.
What they talking about?
And then, like, some couples might think that it's okay to have guy friends, have girlfriends, and they think, you get what I'm saying? That could be another thing, because I know I have close guy friends. So at that point, you know, you gotta just realize that's what I do. I go to my friend's house. If you have girlfriends, then okay, cool. But don't be sitting here really creeping with best friend, and I'm not doing that. You get what I'm saying? So that's another thing that couples have to have a conversation about. And I do agree that it should be in the talking stage because of the fact that when you're in a relationship, now you sitting here going to your friend's house and it's like, yo, what you doing? And it's like, I had these friends before you. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, okay, so that's another thing that, you know, a conversation that needed to be had.
I feel like dating nowadays is like a job application.
It is.
What's a job, period?
Yeah, you gotta look at it, ask questions and shit.
It is.
You gotta work performance reviews and shit.
It's like, you know what? You made it to your 90 day. Like, I didn't think you was gonna do it. You got a lot of call out.
You got the call out. You got the benefits, man.
We're just going to keep it
running. Benefit on it.
Go ahead and sign on this line.
I mean, it's a job. I mean, you know, it's working in the end.
Yeah, it did. But this is
a good relationship.
Yeah, but this is one thing a lot of people, like, I guess what causes a lot of cheating, which not to, you know, backdrag, but people stop working in a relationship. Like, they stop, like, putting effort.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
You know,
better so. Preach.
People stop spitting on it. I told you I was gonna say it. My man, yo, I had to throw that out there.
I agree though with that comment of you saying that people stop working. I do agree because I feel as though even though you like. Don't do all this work to get me. Don't court me. Don't, you know, do all this stuff. And then you get me. It's like, oh, okay, I got it. I don't have to buy flowers anymore. I don't got to do this. I don't have to do that. Like, no, you should still be courting me while we're together. Like, I don't care. Relationship, marriage, anything. You need to court me because you need to keep it interesting. So, yes, I do agree. That's another reason why.
But that goes on both sides, too.
It does.
It's not, you know, like, because some people make it, like one-sided. And, like, that's, you know, that can cause a lot of friction, too, because one person feels like they're doing more than the other or putting more effort into the other. So it all has to be a balance. Like, that's why
I think we've all been in situations like that.
Always. Yeah. I've been in a couple where I felt like I was doing a lot more than, not saying what I should have, but
what the other person was giving.
Yeah, because it was just like, I'm basically dating myself. Like, you know, I mean, like, you're just here. You know, and that's a shitty situation to feel like when you feel like you're dating yourself and you have somebody.
Yeah, because you could do bad all by yourself, for real.
No, it's like, shit, I can talk to myself. I can get more of a fucking answer.
Some people do.
Yeah. I don't know.
I see it every day.
Told you it wasn't going to stop. told y'all, man.
Oh, I want a good-ass move. This is how I was drinking earlier.
Damn.
Oh, man.
I don't know. I think marriage isn't so popular nowadays in our generation.
Because people make it so easy to get, like, you people giving husband and wife vibes without even knowing the person.
Yeah.
So, and no, they feel
like
they don't
need that. Like, Jim Jones and his girlfriend, come on now.
They've been together for 30 years.
For a decade.
But now, but you know what? She wanted she wanted to get married so bad, and Jimmy did it. And now Jimmy wants to get mad, and now she's like, oh no, it's just the paper.
Feng shui is off.
Like,
but you know why he didn't want to get married? Because she touched it in Miami.
Jimmy
Mack,
she's like,
Jimmy,
Miami.
She touched it in Miami. Stop the way, man. Boss Don, Big Bell, Game Green. Oh, man.
What was going to happen?
Boss Dawn season.
He's cutting up today, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, man. But, I mean, honestly, people act like marriage was, like, such better back in the day, but a lot of people just got married just because.
A lot of people got married because he was pregnant, you know?
Yeah.
A lot of people got married right out of high school.
Yeah.
Basically. A lot of people got married in high school. He was engaged in third period.
But you know what? More women, women back in the day, they weren't working. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. So, but now women are more independent. So it's like, fuck that nigga. I don't need that nigga. But back then, it was like, he cheating, but he paying the damn bills, and I don't have no job. So I'm going to stick with my cheating ass husband. Now,
they were doing their own too.
A female, like, I'm out. I don't need you. So I feel like, you know, I think I was born.
What is
the right generation?
You don't really need a person.
You know what? The right generation for me.
Because the 80s, it was crap.
Let me tell you.
The 90s.
No, 90s
too.
No, I don't know. I want to be in like.
70s, it was heroin.
No.
60s, 60s, they just shoot niggas.
I wouldn't want to deal with the civil rights stuff. I wouldn't want to deal with like the that shit. Yeah, not dynamite. Like, I'm just, no.
Well, I would be cutting up with my afro fucking
chest
hair around with the gold chain.
You feel me?
It's already got the fro a little bit. Like,
I would have been a
part of all this shit.
Nah, your fro too. It's too, like, nah, that shit gotta be like.
Hey, man, listen. Because, you know, I got the curls in here. I can't
help it. I gotta be straight.
Give me a hair dryer and a pick. I'll get that shit looking like the 70s. Nigga, if you want.
Looking like one of the Commodores.
Mm-hmm.
No, but to end your question, I think my generation would have been, I feel like the 1920s, but I feel like without, look.
But the black and white,
they ain't had no AC back then.
Listen, no, like without the racism, like the ladies who stayed home, took care of the kids, cooked.
That racism was strong back then.
They didn't give niggas a chance to explain.
that nigga guilty. It's not funny. I'm sorry, but I'm trying not to laugh.
I
wasn't around that time. We wasn't guilty. We wasn't getting to the marriage without even dead already.
Because if I see a clean bathroom, I'm going into the clean bathroom. Fuck what you heard. It is what it is. I'm not sitting in the back. I'm sorry.
I said without the racism. I'm talking about the mentality of men.
What, nicely dressed?
I mean, the 1920s, they was whooping that woman's ass.
Yeah, okay, listen, I'm talking about the protector, the provider, the woman's at home, she's cooking, she's cleaning, she's taking care of the kids.
That nigga was getting drunk, too.
Mm-hmm.
Hell yeah.
That was my
that nigga was having a scotch dinner. Scotch and TV dinner.
That was around prohibition, too.
Oh, that nigga was mad. Didn't the Great Depression follow after that?
Yeah, like, man, I don't know if that's
in the stock market, what was that?
Yeah, that shit crashed. Wall Street crashed. They blew up.
No,
I'm just saying a sense of like the mentality. I just wish that men had more of this.
Maybe the 50s. I don't remember too much bad stuff happening in the 50s.
Yeah, racism.
Well, yeah, besides that.
AKA Mississippi was hot back in the day.
I probably would have lived in Canada somewhere.
What?
Really?
I would have lived in New York.
I didn't know nothing about no damn Canada.
Yeah, man. The slaves was going to Canada.
Word up. And they're living good. They ain't even worry about shit. They can read out loud.
Man, it was just cold as shit.
Yeah. I mean, I can
to a certain extent. that cold different out there. Yeah, we was in Chicago and it was May. It was like, but it's still cold out here. Like, who the fuck had a hoodie on? It was like in the middle of May. That shit fucked me up.
What, you was on 63rd?
Nah. I ain't know
old block.
I ain't know what 63rd was.
Shout out to Vaughn.
I didn't even know what 63rd was back then.
Oh my gosh, they said Emmett Till was from 63rd.
Oh my god.
Emmett Till?
Yeah.
Never knew that. Shout out to Emmett Till.
Them niggas ain't on that block. I'm sorry, I was about to start rapping.
Cutting up.
Yeah, but you know, it's a difficult subject because there's so many ways to look at it and go about it and how people feel about it.
This is tender for me right now because I just got cheated on.
Well, we don't know that yet. Well, it might as well. Nah, he pays.
That's
for the behind the scene footage.
Facts. Well, I mean, it happens. You got Chino, right?
Y'all probably did. I don't know.
So, if you get cheated on, would you rather know or keep it on the low?
No, I want to know. Like, I want
and
to
if be... you're playing me, keep it on the low. Because my heart
I prefer to know. Because it's, you know, you get that closure. Like, other than that, that's it. Like, all right.
It's like, all right, happened. Yeah. All right, cool.
Cool.
Sometimes you, know what happens is happening before.
But you just want to hear it.
Yeah.
I just want to hear it.
Well, there's sometimes, I think the last time I got cheated on, I knew about it. And, you know, it was never actually openly discussed. But, you know,
like, it's like, how does that feel? I'm doing it, though. Like, just knowing. And just being like,
man, what? Yeah. You lose your senses. You lose your taste.
What you mean? You
lose your appetite.
What you lose your spidey senses?
I
just lost y'all superpowers.
I had COVID.
Oh my god.
She said you lose your taste, your hearing, your sight. You can't see shit. Niggas lose their sight and no shit. My stomach, but I can't see.
My chest.
My hearing. Listen, your whole soul leaves your body. Like
Elizabeth from Code of Sea.
It's a big 100.
You remember that Bone Thugs and the Harmony video? That's like, you don't want to miss everybody. He was just taking the bodies out the people. And that was me. I was just like,
you have a crossover. Stomach feeling.
Yo, what? How does it feel?
Shout out to CJ, man.
How does it feel?
Oh, man.
How does it feel?
I mean, there's different emotions. There's anger, you know, betrayal.
It's the audacity for me, like.
I more so felt some type of way.
Yeah, because it's just like, me, it's like, why? It's like, just break up with me. It's like, if that's how you feel, break up with me. Mm-hmm. That shit, like, you know, like, when a person.
One time I didn't really care because we was cheating on each other, so. Damn. It was like, so. I was waiting for you to tell me.
She was like, you do the Spider-Man shit.
So, I mean, it was like that, but, you know. Yeah, man, you move on. Eventually, you know, time heals all wounds.
Yeah.
You move on, you become a better person.
I feel like you learn for, like, situations like that.
Some people do. Some people don't.
I feel like you...
More so they don't. I've seen a lot of people don't learn. Don't learn from situations, man.
Yeah, but I feel like you should learn. Like, you should learn. Not, like, just for yourself, but just learn, like, the subtle signs. Like, or just learn next time you have a stomach feeling, mm-hmm. then go with the stomach feeling and ask a question. Mm-hmm. Instead of just putting it off. Because a lot of people, you know, I just don't want to argue. And it's like, it's not an argument. We're having a simple conversation. You know, sometimes it's all about how you approach a person. You know, your demeanor, your aura.
No, like, that's not true. Because I approached a person... with, I approached a person with a comment.
How was it presented?
Yeah, was the comment sarcastic?
No, it was presented in a look. I'm not trying to argue. I just want you to know this.
Okay.
And I said a comment.
But you said you're not.
And just because it was something that they didn't want to hear, they took it as an argument. So you can sit here and present a situation to a person as peaceful as possible. It's how they take it. You get what I'm saying? It's how the person receives it. Sometimes you can sit here and say everything in the nicest way you can just to avoid an argument. Mm-hmm. And how they take it, maybe they just don't want to hear that right now. Oh my God, y'all trying to argue. Now y'all sitting here arguing about something that you brought up.
That you say you didn't want to argue about.
Exactly. So.
In that sense, you got to be like, you know what? I tell you what.
Tell you what.
I'm gonna head out. You got this. You good. You got it. I feel like if a person gets that defenseless over, like, you know, a question, like, it's like, you gave me all the answer. I need to know.
Yeah.
Is that a sticky pistol?
Is that a red flag?
Yeah. The fuck you getting hyped for? Like, I'm one of those people, when I go into an argument or like a disagreement, I don't look to argue. I don't have an argumental voice. I'm calm. So when you start snapping at me, I'm gonna start flipping out. because it's like, the fuck wrong with you? Like, why are you mad?
Some people like arguing, man.
I don't.
Some people mad that you won't argue back with them.
Mm-hmm.
I shoot jump shots.
From the pistons?
Mm-hmm. No, I'm hoodie mellow in the argument. Yeah. I'm shooting.
Why are you so calm? I'm supposed to be upset.
I'm supposed to yell at you. Like, we're having a conversation.
Yeah, a yell and screaming match.
Yeah. I mean, I could. That's what you want.
Mm.
I get angry. I get mad. I start snapping when I feel like stupidity just really, like, the shit. I hate stupidity. It's like, I know you heard what the fuck I said.
Right.
That's when things start turning dark skins.
Yo, that's how niggas start turning green.
I'm
about to start flipping
cards. I'm Hulk.
but shit could be avoided.
So do you think that there's somebody, marriages out there, or people who really don't cheat?
Yeah. There's a bunch of people that don't cheat. But they don't, you know, but I'm not going to say I don't get recognition. That's not. There's a bunch of people.
Yeah, you just see, speaking of recognition, you just see they was just clowning Sierra, what's Russell Wilson for saying he loved his wife so much and he's scared to lose her. And people were clowning him for saying that. And it's like, but if he was Future saying that these bitches were streets and dogging bitches,
that all depends on the people. Who were the people that were clowning him?
Yeah, true.
That goes who the people that are clowning him. That goes to show you the type of people that they
like
are.
You taking
God, I commend that.
You like the energy you receive is from the certain people that you receive it from, it just like it determines a lot.
Yeah.
So if you're receiving a certain energy from people that think like, you know, Future or whatever case may be, then you know, it might be like, oh, I don't care about that.
Think you're a cornball. Right. He loves his girl, you know, but he's just a guy that loves his girl. Like,
there's guys that love a woman like that. And then
there's guys just, that love their friends. Yeah.
And, then there's people for the
streets. I fucking hate that.
Dude, wait, what happened?
There's dudes that love their friends more than their girl. I just think that's the gayest shit in the world. You want to hang out with your friends all the time. Like, don't get me wrong, I love my friend. Bro, I love you. Mm-hmm. I'm not hanging around your Twitter.
Well, I know how you get when you get in a relationship.
We're not going to talk about
it. We're going to talk about it. Because if this thing ever get in a relationship again, these Lit Logic episodes is going to dwindle down.
That's crazy. No, it's not. Don't listen to him.
He says going
dwindle down. Why the fuck you laying like that?
That nigga feels sexy.
Yeah, right? That nigga put the hoodie on and everything. I changed. I can show you how this nigga look right now.
He's practicing
for the Magic Mike show. He's about to perform tonight.
I got my boxers too.
Come on, we need to know that.
Quay got his gym bag in the car.
Back to what I was saying about this nigga. Yeah, when this nigga get a girlfriend, we don't see him too much, man. I remember the last time. Oh, wow. We used to play the game all the time.
Wow.
Then that nigga got booed up. I think I saw him maybe.
Thing. I see that's him, how it is.
I think I seen him twice in a couple, like 2 months. Like,
you know what? And I can explain that about myself. I'm not an over the top clingy person, so when I meet somebody I actually really like, I actually am pretty. I don't.
You going?
Yeah, I don't. I'm not a clingy person. I don't like that shit. So when I meet somebody I like, that's just how I am.
Aww.
It's weird.
That nigga be in love.
No.
Shout out to Stepdad Season.
Hey yo, this is Lit Logic's magic. Come on, so I can take these shots.
We got a special surprise for y'all after this that we going.
Yeah, I lost the bet. Shout out to Teflon Tom, number 7, you know. Yeah, probably plus, you know, because he probably gonna go back.
They're gonna repeat. Yeah, you know. Yeah, man. Never go against Tom. I told you that.
I got to take these shots, man. I'm doing like a champ.
Good boy. Appreciate that.
Yeah.
Wait, I thought you were taking the shots because it was your birthday.
No. What? Mm-hmm. My birthday's in September.
So I came in the house and I gave you
a I didn't know why you said happy birthday. I just agreed with you.
That nigga Quay was talking about what he was doing for his birthday.
Yeah, that's why. Because G was like, happy birthday. I was like, all right, thank you.
Thank you. What the fuck going on Lit Logic, man?
A lot of lit.
I see.
Oh, okay.
Oh, man.
Well, you guys, I always have fun here with you guys. So you guys going to invite me back again?
Of course. You're like only one of our only female guests that come here consistently.
Literally.
Shout out to Maxie. That's the woman of the house.
Yep, shout out to Mom. Hi, babe. I'm looking at the camera and looking at you at the same time.
Love her life.
Yeah,
she's goals.
Great.
Love you guys.
Before we end, I just wanted to say how, you know, I found it funny how all my other friends get to call her Max except me. I can't do it. But that's a topic for another day. You already know what to do. Like, comment, share.
Drop those hearts.
Subscribe. Hit the little notification bell. You will get notified every time a video drops.
And definitely call 911 for me because these shots are going to burn my stomach.
Yeah, this nigga about to die.
Absolutely. Pray for me, Lit Logic fans.
Nigga, beard about to sizzle.
I don't have one.
Whatever little one that you got.
Oh, your beard was supposed to sizzle. Tom was supposed to lose. Yeah, his chin strap was supposed to be on fire. This is some bullshit.
Now it's about to be.
These niggas went to the Super Bowl and kicked 3 field goals. How? How do you have a whole 2 weeks to prepare for a Super Bowl just to kick 3 field goals? Hey, y'all did this to me. Now I gotta take these damn shots.
We want to thank our guest, Megan, for coming through.
Thank you guys for having me. I'll have a good time on here. You guys are great, and I love this show.
Well, we appreciate that.
Absolutely.
You already know. Until next time, I'm Jay.
I'm B.
This is Lit Logic. Catch y'all next time. Peace.
Hey. Quay, how many?